aside from like the guys who trained me, you're the first person that I ever like considered a mentor. Cause in my time over there, so I was like 19 years old. I was still in college and then eventually like grad school. So I was just always studying over at the little, or the little tables next to that, the building that we weren't supposed to go into with the parking lot. Yeah. It was a yeah. weird place, everybody. Yeah, so I would just kind of study in this quiet area. But as you know, like I didn't have a ton of friends. I wasn't like super, I guess like quote unquote, like over with like the boys, especially the older dudes, the vets. And so when I ended up getting released, Devon called me and he was like, you just explained to me, like, you know how I'm feeling. And I went into this whole tirade about like, I'm not good enough to like keep a job wrestling. So like, why should I send myself other places? Like, I should just go ahead and like do school stuff and, you know, just don't think about it anymore. I had my shot. I apparently wasn't good enough. I should just stop. And you told me that if that's what I honestly wanted to do, then I should. But if I love wrestling and if I love wrestling as much as you think I love wrestling, he said, just send your stuff to WWE. Get back on the indies, bounce around, send your stuff to WWE. It's going to work out. And so like that's that like 2-hour conversation, one of the best conversations I've had in my life, because I was at, it was like at one of my lowest points and you were there for me to like pick me up off the ground, dust me off and say, no, go be somebody. And so I will forever be in your debt for that. And it just kind of speaks to the kind of guy you are.
No, you know, I know how it was growing up, not having anybody around to really give you, you know, the sense of how to survive and how to do things. And then walking up into this business, I wasn't a second generation wrestler, third generation, like some of the guys that come in. I basically learned by putting my trust in some people, and some people that got burned, you know, other people, you know, they were helpful, but they still had their own agenda. And I just remember, you know, saying to myself, and this is the God's honest truth, if I ever had the opportunity to help somebody, if I ever made it past where I was, that I was basically going to do the same and help them out the way I felt that I wanted to get helped out. And when I saw you, I saw the potential. I saw everything that you were doing. I loved the Apollo Creed gimmick that you were doing because it was based off the Rocky movies. And my character is from Mr. T and Samuel L. Jackson. And so when I saw that, I remember seeing you in the costume and everything popped huge. And I remember coming to you and even reciting Mr. T stit, you know, because, you know, you were Apollo and all that. So you and I hit. I saw the respect. I saw everything that you were doing. And what impressed me the most was that you were also gifted up here in the mind. You were studying. You were doing what you had to do just in case this business didn't work out for you. And a lot of us don't do that. A lot of us just go, you know, head first into it and without thinking of what's going to happen. Well, you did that. And I remember telling you, go ahead and get your education. It'll come. Stick with it.
When I was in middle school, me and my buddy, Billy Fagan, Billy Fagan's mom took us to ECW shows in the Cobb County Civic Center. Billy's mom has never seen ECW before, but we've somehow convinced her to take us to this place. After the first match, she was like, we need to leave now. Y'all are in seventh grade. We cannot be here. And that's when the Dudley Boys came out and they had the mic and they were ripping into everyone in that building. It's a civic center, but it's packed. So people are like hanging from the rafters. You know how ECW was. Yeah, oh, WrestlePalooza 98. There we go.
Okay.
So the Dudley Boys start cutting a promo and we're sitting in like the first set of rafters on the second level. So we're right next to the edge. And I remember Bubba said, we could kick everybody's in this building. Who wants to fight? And the college kids behind us, like we were talking to them about wrestling, how we wanted to be wrestlers when we grew up. So they started up, they're like, these kids. So we're like, yeah. And Bubba said the worst thing ever. to Billy's mom, as she was about to leave and take us out of the building, he said something to her that fired her up, and she went back and sat down. She goes, I'm gonna see these guys get their ass kicked.
Do you want more? Of course you do. Subscribe wherever you get your podcasts and feel the power.